Good morning, everyone. Let's begin with your doubts. We did a yes to yesterday. Please post your doubts. Quickly post it out so that we can begin with revising and then continuing S2. Okay, fine. I guess there are no doubts. So let's begin with S2. We did S2 valuation of inventory, where we first understood that valuation of inventory is crucial. Why? Because one, inventory affects two things. One, your profitability, and second, your financial position. So that is why it is important that we have an accounting standard on inventory. Then we understood, if we make an accounting standard on inventory, what will be the objective of the accounting standard? There will be two objectives. One, to lay down principles to be considered in computing the value of inventory, and to ensure adequate disclosures of the policy by each. Then AS2 does not apply to WIP arising under construction contracts, including directly related service contracts, WIP arising in the ordinary course of business of service providers, shares, debentures, other financial instruments held as stock in trade, and finally, producers' inventory of livestock, agriculture, forest products, mineral oils, ores, and gases, to the extent they are measured as at the NRV. Why are they measured as at NRV? As per the well-established practices in those industries. So to these specific industries and their products, AS2 is not applicable. Why? Because they are usually measured at NRV. Because they are usually measured at NRV, hum unko bolte hain ki jab aapko NRV pehle din se pata hai aur aap NRV pe hi record karne wale hain, aap cost or NRV, whichever is lower, follow hi mat kijiye. In short, aap AS2 hi follow mat kijiye. You only take the NRV, and you directly get your value of the inventory. No need to calculate cost or NRV, and that is why they are kept out of the ambit of accounting standard. Right, so Akshay, I guess that was your doubt, and that is now solved. Then we did two questions, question number 1 and 2. Then we did, what is the meaning of inventory? You all told me that inventory is recorded on the asset side of the balance sheet. So inventories are assets which are held for sale in the ordinary course of business. They are held in the process of production for such sale. They are held in the form of material or supplies to be consumed in the production process. So this covers finished goods, raw material, WIP, and spares and consumables. After that, we did that if one machinery can be used only in connection with one fixed asset, then it will be recorded with that fixed asset as per accounting standard 10. However, if one spare part can be used commonly with more than one assets, then in that case, we will record it as per accounting standard 2. And then we said that, and then we understood that servicing equipment will now also be treated the same way. If it follows the definition of AS10, it will go with AS10, or it will be recorded as per AS2. We understood the entire concept, and then we decided that the containers and empties will be treated as items of inventory. After that, we understood कि हमको AS2 क्यों बनाया, AS2 में क्या-क्या cover नहीं होने वाला है. We also understood the basics of accounting standard 2. What is the meaning of inventory? What does spare part include? What it does not include? Now, finally, it was time for us to understand the valuation norm. So the valuation norm we have been studying since the 11th standard is cost or NRV, whichever is lower. We also understood the entire concept yesterday. Why it is cost or NRV, whichever is lower? Because we strictly follow the prudence concept. If there is any future gains, you cannot anticipate that. But if there are future expected losses, you need to provide that in the books today. After that, we did what does cost include. So cost will include the purchase price, duties and taxes that are non-refundable, freight, other expenses directly attributable to the acquisition. There we took the example of insurance, in-transit insurance. We also took the example of a security guard. Right, this much we have done till yesterday. Quickly, I'm asking you again, if you have any doubts, please post it. Okay, I have one doubt, which is why the freight to bring goods from godown to showroom is not included in the cost of goods, because without bringing in them to the showroom, how will we be able to sell it? Yes, I agree with you, but that is not direct expense, that is indirect expense. Direct expense was when you got it from the factory to the godown. That is your direct expense. So unloading, loading, everything at the go down is your direct expense. That is why the rates are always X factory rates, or sorry, X go down rates. The rates are always X go down rates, because you have them unloaded at the go down, and then from go down you bring it to your showroom. From go down to showroom is always an indirect expense. So that will not be considered. Only direct expenses will be considered over here. Right, so I hope that is clear to you. Okay, great. Fine, if there are no more doubts, let's proceed to the next one, which says cost of purchase excludes. Cost of purchase mein kya kya exclude hoga? First, refundable duties and taxes. So refundable duties and taxes will not be included over here. Trade discount will not be included over here. Rebates, duty drawback and other similar items. All these things will not be included in your cost of purchase. So refundable duties and taxes will not be there. Trade discount, of course, we never include. Rebate is also a kind of refundable amount that you get back. Other similar items is again same for which you are getting reimbursed. Now please understand duty drawback. What happens in duty drawback is earlier, what used to happen was earlier, government gave incentives on exports. Now, a lot of people started misusing those incentives on exports. So the government said that only after you export, which means at the time of export, you pay the duty. When you come back to us, give us the proof that you have actually exported all the goods. You show the bill of lading, you show all the proper documents. Then whatever duty you have paid at the time of export, that we will reimburse to you, which is known as duty drawback. So again, duty drawback is a kind of reimbursable tax and duty. Because it is a reimbursable tax and duty, again, it is excluded from the cost of purchase. Why? Because it is a refundable tax and duty. Are you getting it? So again, what does cost of purchase include? It includes purchase price, duties and taxes, non-refundable freight, and other expenses directly attributable to the acquisition. That is interest on qualifying asset. The cost of purchase excludes refundable duties and taxes, trade discount, rebates, duty drawback, and other similar items. Right? Okay. After that, you have, if inventories are qualifying assets within the meaning of AS 16, then it forms part of the borrowing. Then the borrowing cost forms part of inventory. Now, this we have already done the entire standard on AS 16. So I hope you all will understand this, that if your inventory takes more than substantial period of time to get ready for its intended use or sale, and you have taken a loan for it on which you are paying interest, then at that interest you can add to the cost of the inventory. Why? Because it will be treated as a qualifying asset, and qualifying asset will be added to the cost of the inventory. Are you getting it? Absolutely simple point this is. Right, if you're clear till this, let's try question number 3. So please take your notebooks, have a pen and calculator with you. This is a practical accounting standard, and we have 27 questions in this accounting standard. So let's try and solve each and every question and ensure that you practice all these when you go back. Question number three. Let's solve question number three. An enterprise ordered 10,000 kgs of certain material at rupees 90 per kg. Kitna material kharida? 10,000 kg. Kya price tha? 90 rupees per kg. The purchase price includes isko GST kar do. The purchase price includes GST of rupees 4 per kg in respect of which input tax credit is admissible. In respect of which input tax credit is admissible. Freight is rupees 50,500. Other non-recoverable duties and taxes are 10,000 rupees. Karna kya hai? Calculate the cost of inventory. Okay, let's calculate that. Put your first statement. Question number three. Put your first statement as per accounting standard. Two, valuation of inventories. This is given to you on page 19. Put your first statement as per accounting standard 2, valuation of inventories. Karna kya hai question mein? Calculate cost of inventory. So put your next statement. Calculation of cost of inventory. Prepare this systematic format. Prepare a proper format, draw proper lines, avoid shortcuts, solve along with me. Okay, let's begin. The first thing that is given to you is, let's look at the question. It says enterprise ordered 10,000 kgs of certain material at rupees 90 per kg. So what's your purchase price? Purchase price will be 10,000 kgs multiply by rupees 90 per kg. 10,000 kgs multiply by rupees 90 per kg. You get how much? 9 lakhs. Now understand, in the purchase price, you have 4 rupees GST. It is included. See, they have mentioned over here. Purchase price includes. Matlab purchase price ke andar included hai. Kya GST? So let's deduct that. Since input tax credit is available, this is a refundable tax and duty. Because it is a refundable tax and duty, we will have to deduct it. GST into brackets, input tax credit available. Note 2. How much input tax credit is available? 4 rupees per kg is what they have said. So 10,000 into 4 will be 40,000. Do show you are working over here. 10,000. Kgs into rupees 4 per kg. How much do you get? 8,60,000. You get 8,60,000. Next, they tell you that freight incurred is 50,500. So freight will also be added. 50,500. Why did we add that? We will mention that at note 1. Now, the reason for including purchase price and freight is the same. So let's not waste our time in the exam by writing the same note twice. You can give a common working note 1 and working note 2. And then you can have a common answer for them. So prepare a common working note. No need to have duplication. Okay, next, other non-recoverable duties and taxes. Other non-recoverable duties and taxes will also be added because it is non-refundable. 10,000. Other non-recoverable duties and taxes are 10,000, they will also be added. What's your total? Now, please don't add from 9 lakhs. Don't make that silly mistake. 8,60,000 plus 50,500 plus 10,000. This is your cost of inventory. First, let's put the notes as well. First, purchase price, comma, freight, and non-refundable duties and taxes shall be included while calculating cost of inventory. Second, as per AS2, valuation of inventory, GST is a refundable tax and duty in this case, and hence the same shall be excluded while calculating the cost of inventory. Very simple question, once was asked in the exam. Absolutely simple, nothing to do with it. All you should know is this part. You should know this part carefully. What will you include? What will you exclude? Take this down properly. If you have any doubts, please post it on the chat box. done with this? Any doubts in this? Okay, if you're done with this, let's go to the next one. I hope you all are clear and there are no doubts in this. Okay, come to the next one, which is cost of conversion. Page number 20. Come to the next one, cost of conversion. Now, please understand what is the meaning of cost of conversion. Cost of conversion means you are trying to convert your raw material into your WIP or finished goods. Right? अभी तक हमने raw material के बारे में पढ़ा कि raw material को purchase करते वक्त cost कैसे calculate करने का. अब जब आप raw material से WIP की तरफ मुड़ेंगे तब आगे बढ़ेंगे तो WIP का भी cost ढूंढना पड़ेगा. Now this part cost of conversion is nothing but conversion of your raw material to WIP or your finished goods. So please pay attention what will be added over here. You have cost of conversion, which is directly related, cost directly related to production, which is your direct labor. So when do you use your labor? When you have some process going on the raw material. So your direct labor is your direct cost. Second, directly attributable manufacturing cost. So you have some direct manufacturing cost that will also be included. Fixed production overheads, that is your rent. So fixed production overheads will also be included. And variable production overheads will be included. So cost of conversion mein basically kya kya aata hai? Direct labor, directly attributable manufacturing cost, fixed production overheads and variable production overheads. Next sentence dekho. Fixed production overheads represent indirect cost of production. So fixed production overheads kya hai? Indirect cost of production. It is not a direct cost. Fixed production overheads is an indirect cost. Aage dekho. They will remain relatively constant regardless of the volume of production. Now you have already studied costing, where it says that the fixed overheads will always remain relatively constant irrespective of the volume of production. It is the variable cost that will vary with your production or volume of production. But fixed production overheads will never vary from your volume of production. It will remain fixed. Fixed production overheads are to be allocated on the basis of normal capacity. Very important. Underline this. Fixed production overheads will be allocated on the basis of your normal capacity. मतलब fixed production overheads हर एक unit पे कैसे allot करने का, allocate करने का on the basis of your normal capacity. Normal capacity के basis पे हम fixed production overheads को हर एक unit पे allocate करेंगे. अब question ये है कि normal capacity होता क्या है? Normal capacity is the production expected by an enterprise over a number of periods under normal circumstances. मतलब normal capacity का मतलब क्या है कि हम कितना production एक machinery से expect कर सकते हैं over a number of periods, लेकिन normal circumstances में double shift, triple shift, four times shift ये सब नहीं. Normal working hours में machine कितना production करेगा वो taking into account, ध्यान देना please, taking into account loss of capacity resulting from planned maintenance. सब ध्यान देना. हम ऐसा सोचते हैं कि एक महीने में मशीन 10,000 यूनिट बना सकता है नॉर्मल सर्कमस्टेंसेस में. तो मैंने लिख दिया 10,000 एक महीने का, लेकिन महीने में दो दिन ऐसे रहेंगे जब सब फैक्ट्री बंद रहेगी क्योंकि सारे मशीन का मेंटेनेंस चलेगा. क्योंकि सारे मशीन का मेंटेनेंस चलेगा तब तो मशीन प्रोडक्शन नहीं कर पाएगी, विच मीन्स वी आर गोइंग टू लूज आउट ऑन द प्रोडक्शन. वाई? बिकॉज वी हैव planned maintenance of the machinery. तो क्योंकि आपका units आप उस time पे manufacture नहीं करने वाले, आप अपने total expected production में से वो planned maintenance के वक्त जो loss होने वाला है उसको आप minus कर देंगे. So that is taking into account the loss of capacity which results from your planned maintenance. Are you getting it? Again, let's quickly revise this. What is the meaning of cost of conversion? The cost that you will incur while you convert the raw material into WIP or finished goods. Cost directly related to production, directly attributable manufacturing cost, fixed production overheads, variable production overheads, and then fixed production overheads is nothing but your indirect cost of production. And as every indirect cost, this will also remain constant regardless of the volume of production. Fixed production overheads, they have told us that we have to always take on the basis of normal capacity of production. What is normal capacity of production? The production that the entity will expect over a number of periods under normal circumstances, while you take into account the loss of capacity resulting from your planned maintenance. Are you getting it? Simple as it is. Okay. Let's take the next table. Come to page number 21. Come to page number 21. Now, if you understand this carefully, it will be very easy for you. Come to page number 21. Okay, now please pay attention. It says, if actual period, ye period nahi hona chahiye, if actual capacity hona chahiye. If actual capacity is equal to normal capacity of production, there is no under recovery of overheads. Now please understand, I am quickly reading this through. Then we will take one example completely. We'll try and understand that example. And after that, we will go to, we'll come back to this and read this. So please pay attention. I am just reading this through. Then we go to one example, which will clarify everything. And then we come back to this. Second case, actual production is lower than normal capacity of production. There is under recovery of overheads. Do not consider unabsorbed overheads for valuation of inventory, treated as a period cost. And finally, actual production overheads is greater than the normal production, normal capacity of production. This is over absorption of overheads. The recovery rate will be suitably lowered, which will ensure that the inventories are not measured above cost. Okay, now please pay attention. Let me give you a proper example for this. Let's take your fixed production overheads. Your fixed production overheads is how much? Say, for example, 5 lakhs. Your fixed production overheads is 5 lakhs. Say, for example, your normal capacity of production is 1000 units. Okay, everyone on your chat box, please pay attention to what I'm asking, and everyone on your chat box. If my fixed production overheads is 5 lakhs and my normal capacity of production is 1000, can you tell me what is my cost fixed production overhead per unit? What is my fixed production overhead per unit? On your chat box, everyone. Spruha, can you explain to me how 5 rupees? Can you tell me how 5 rupees? Aman, can you tell me how 5 rupees? Of course, your fixed production overhead per unit will be how much? 5 rupees. Right? Pay attention. Why will it be 5 rupees? Dhyan dena jo main bol raha hu. It will be 5 rupees because we have been told that fixed production overheads will always be allocated on the basis of normal capacity of production. So normal capacity kitna is question mein? 1000. So 5 lakh divided by 1000, how much do you get? 500. Har question mein yehi karna hai. Lekin maan lo, agar aisa aata hai, case 1, actual capacity case 2, actual capacity, and case 3, actual capacity. Dhyan dena, full attention should be on what I am saying. Case 1 mein maan lijiye aapki actual capacity kitni hai? 500. केस टू में से फॉर एग्जांपल आपकी एक्चुअल कैपेसिटी 625 है और केस थ्री में आपकी एक्चुअल कैपेसिटी 450 है. लेट्स सॉल्व केस वन फर्स्ट. टेल मी इन केस वन एक्चुअल कैपेसिटी इज इक्वल टू नॉर्मल कैपेसिटी, एक्चुअल कैपेसिटी इज ग्रेटर देन नॉर्मल कैपेसिटी और एक्चुअल कैपेसिटी इज लेसर देन नॉर्मल कैपेसिटी. पुट इट ऑन योर चैट बॉक्स क्विकली एंड एवरीवन प्लीज. ओके वेरी गुड, एवरीवन अग्रीज इट इज इक्वल टू. इशिका हाउ इज इट लेसर देन, कैन यू प्लीज एक्सप्लेन टू मी इन केस वन. इशिका हाउ इज इट लेसर देन, ओके इट इज इक्वल टू. ओके Can someone explain to me the meaning of actual capacity? Can someone explain to me on the chat box the meaning of actual capacity? I'm sorry, this will be 1000. So let's make this 800 and let's make this 1200. I'm sorry, I made a mistake over there. Okay, so is your actual capacity equal to normal capacity? Yes, it is equal to normal capacity. Ab dhyan dena. What is the meaning of actual capacity? Aapne actually kitna produce kiya? That is your actual capacity. What is normal capacity? What is expected of you that you will manufacture? अब हमारे केस में actual capacity is equal to normal capacity. मतलब हमने ऐसा उम्मीद किया था कि 1000 यूनिट बनेंगे और हमने एक्चुअली भी 1000 यूनिट बनाए. मतलब न ज्यादा बनाए न कम बनाए, क्योंकि न ज्यादा बनाए देर इज नो ओवर रिकवरी, न कम बनाए इसलिए देर इज नो अंडर रिकवरी. सो वी हैव करेक्टली मैन्युफैक्चर्ड द यूनिट्स. इन दिस केस व्हाट वी विल डू इज वी विल हैव 5 लाख divided by 1000. What will be the cost per unit? 500. Are you getting it? Absolutely simple this is. Because your actual capacity is equal to your normal capacity of production, your actual capacity and normal capacity are equal, which means you have neither produced more nor you have produced less. Since you have not produced more or less, there is no under recovery or over recovery. Because there is no under recovery or over recovery, we have rightly produced. All we have to do is 5 lakhs divided by 1000. You have rupees 500 per unit as fixed production overheads per unit. Right? I hope everyone is clear with that. Come to case 2. If you look at case 2, it says we have actual capacity of 800. Normal capacity is 1000. Everyone on your chat box, less than, equal to or greater than. Less than, equal to or greater than. Everyone quickly on your chat box. Right, I request everyone to respond so that I understand that you are getting my points. Less than, equal to or greater than. Okay, less than. Now please pay attention what you will do. Maan lijiye if it is less than, which means हम 1000 यूनिट बना सकते थे पर हमने कितना बनाया 800 पर यूनिट. कम बनाया. क्यों कम बनाया पता नहीं है मगर कम बनाया. अब देखो होगा क्या. इफ यू टेक्निकली कैलकुलेट 5 लाख यू विल हैव टू डिवाइड बाय 800. हाउ मच डू यू गेट डिवाइड बाय 800. योर कॉस्ट कम्स टू 625. इज योर कॉस्ट इंक्रीजिंग येस और नो ऑन योर चैट बॉक्स. इज योर कॉस्ट इंक्रीजिंग येस. From 500, it is now increasing to 625. Which means, मैंने कम प्रोड्यूस किया, ध्यान देना जो मैं बोल रहा हूँ. Which clearly means, मैंने अपनी कैपेसिटी से कम प्रोड्यूस किया. कम प्रोड्यूस किया तो इन्वेंट्री का कॉस्ट ज्यादा आया. इसी कॉस्ट पे मैं बैलेंस शीट पे रिकॉर्ड करूंगा. मतलब मेरी इन्वेंट्री दूसरे की इन्वेंट्री से ज्यादा वैल्यू की दिखेगी. पर यह तो एक्चुअली गलत बात है. The one who is producing less than his capacity, how can he be better than the others? The accounting standard board said, in spite of the fact that you have 800 actual capacity, you will still continue to divide by 1000, which means how much will go to the cost of inventory? 500 rupees. Are you getting it? Again, I am repeating for you. 5 lakh overhead, 5 lakh fixed production overhead cost hai. Normal capacity hai 1000 rupees. Matlab cost per unit kitna aya? 500. Wo case 1 ki baat ho gayi. Case 2 mein actually humne kitna produce kiya? 800. Lekin accounting standard 2 says always and always take it on the normal capacity of production. So we took that at normal capacity of production. Why? Because there is under recovery of overheads. आप हजार यूनिट बना सकते थे पर आपने ठीक से प्रोडक्शन मैनेज नहीं किया इसलिए आपके कितने यूनिट्स बने 800 यूनिट बने. आर यू गेटिंग इट? सो अकाउंटिंग स्टैंडर्ड बोर्ड द अकाउंटिंग स्टैंडर्ड 2 सेज यू विल स्टिल कंटिन्यू टू डिवाइड बाय द नॉर्मल कैपेसिटी ऑफ प्रोडक्शन एंड वी विल अलाउ यू टू अलोकेट टू द कॉस्ट एट नॉर्मल कैपेसिटी ऑफ प्रोडक्शन. मतलब केस 1 वाला अपनी इन्वेंट्री में कितना फिक्स प्रोडक्शन ओवरहेड ऐड करेगा? 500 रुपए. केस 2 वाला कितना ऐड करेगा? वो भी 500 रुपए ऐड करेगा. राइट? अब ध्यान देना. सी दिस इज अ लिटिल बिट टेक्निकल कंसेप्ट. सो लेट मी कंप्लीट द एंटायर थिंग. वंस आई कंप्लीट द एंटायर थिंग ट्रस्ट मी यू विल अंडरस्टैंड एवरीथिंग. सो राइट नाउ यू मे फील के क्या हो रहा है, हमको समझ में नहीं आ रहा, बट जस्ट स्टे देयर, जस्ट स्टे विद मी. इफ यू जस्ट फोकस एट द एंड यू विल अंडरस्टैंड एवरीथिंग. इफ यू लूज फोकस, इफ यू लीव इट इन बिटवीन, देन not today, any day you will not be able to understand anything. So please pay attention. अब आपको ऐसा question आना चाहिए कि sir actual खर्चा तो ये हुआ 5 lakhs divided by 800 which comes to how much? 625. Actual खर्चा तो 625 हुआ. I agree with you that the actual cost is 625. Now tell me out of 625 actual cost how much did we allocate to the cost of inventory? Can you tell me that? Out of 625, how much did we allocate to the cost of inventory? Everyone gets 500. How much did we allocate to the cost of inventory? How much did we allocate to the cost of inventory? We allocated how much? Yes, what you are saying is correct. We allocated 500. 625 total खर्चा हुआ. हमने allocate कितना किया? 500. तो कितना बच गया? $625 में से $500 allocate हुआ. तो how much is still left to be allocated? The amount that is left now is 125. So 125 will be treated as a period cost and will be debited to profit and loss account. What will happen to 125? It will be treated as a period cost and will be debited to the profit and loss account. Now please understand the argument that the accounting standard board does. The accounting standard board says कि देखो हमने आपके लिए normal capacity of production ढंग से calculate किया था. क्यों ढंग से बोल रहा हूँ मैं? क्योंकि मैंने normal circumstances ही लिए थे कि normally इतना manufacture होगा. उससे ज़्यादा तो आप कर ही सकते हो double shift करके, लेकिन normally इतना manufacture होगा. मैंने in fact जब आप maintenance करोगे तब production नहीं करोगे ये भी मैंने minus कर दिया था. Planned level of maintenance भी मैंने आपको minus करके दिया. उसके बाद भी इतना सब करने के बाद मैंने 1000 यूनिट्स आपको बताया आपकी नॉर्मल कैपेसिटी है. फिर भी अगर आप 800 यूनिट बनाते हो तो ये हमारा प्रॉब्लम नहीं है, आप लोग का प्रॉब्लम है. ये आपकी गलती है, हमारी गलती नहीं है कि आप कम प्रोडक्शन कर रहे हो. राइट? आप ऐसा चाहते हो कि हम कम प्रोडक्शन करें फिर भी हमारा कॉस्ट पर यूनिट ज्यादा है ताकि हमारी इन्वेंट्री बैलेंस शीट में और ट्रेडिंग में ज्यादा दिखे ताकि हमारा जीपी भी बढ़ जाए. तो दैट इज नॉट करेक्ट. वी विल ऑन एनी गिवन डे वी विल नॉट अलाउ दैट. सो प्लीज अंडरस्टैंड, आपने कम प्रोड्यूस किया है, हमारा प्रॉब्लम नहीं है. हमने तो आपको ढंग से सब कैलकुलेट करके दिया था. नाउ बिकॉज यू हैव प्रोड्यूस्ड लेस इट इज जेन्युइनली नॉट माय प्रॉब्लम, इट इज रियली योर प्रॉब्लम. आपकी गलती है, आपका प्रॉब्लम है. और क्योंकि आपकी गलती आपका प्रॉब्लम है, हम आपको कोई कंसिडरेशन नहीं देंगे, आप अभी भी 1000 यूनिट से ही डिवाइड करेंगे, आपका जितना भी खर्चा एक्स्ट्रा रहा है वो कहाँ पे चले जाएगा, दैट विल क्लियरली गो टू द प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस अकाउंट. व्हाई? बिकॉज दैट इज योर पीरियड कॉस्ट एंड पीरियड कॉस्ट विल ऑलवेज गो टू द प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस अकाउंट. आर यू गेटिंग इट? ओके, कम टू केस नंबर 3. आफ्टर दैट वी विल टेक योर डाउट्स. इनफैक्ट आफ्टर केस नंबर 3 ऑल्सो आई विल गिव यू वन अनदर एग्जाम्पल. If you understand that, I think everything will be clear to you. Case number 3. Case number 3 में आपने हमको कहा 1000 यूनिट बनाओ. हमने अपनी सारी रिसोर्सेज लगा दिए और कितना मैन्युफैक्चर किया? 1200. Now we manufactured 1200, 1200 units. Tell me, did you produce more, less or equal? More, less or equal? More, less or equal? Everyone on your chat box. Everyone on your chat box. More, less or equal? Yes, of course. It will be. It is more. Now see what happens. Now the industry says कि सर याद है आपने हमको यहाँ जबरदस्ती 1000 यूनिट करवाया था, यहाँ पे भी 1000 यूनिट ही आप हमको अलाउ करना भले हमने 1200 बनाया. क्यों? क्योंकि अगर 1200 से डिवाइड करेंगे तो हमारा कॉस्ट कम हो जाएगा. The accounting standard board says that is not possible. You will have to do 5 lakh divided by 1200, which will come to how much? 416. Let's take round figure 415. Now please understand. The accounting standard board said कि हम आपको 415 ही allow करेंगे. We cannot allow you 500. The industry got very furious. They got angry. कि सर ये कैसा? जब आपको 1000 से divide करना है तब 1000 से divide करते हैं. अब तो हमने ज़्यादा produce किया, तो भी हम क्यों 1000 से divide नहीं कर सकते? Why should we take 1200? Then the accounting standard board explained. And everyone, please help me with the answer. If I allow you 500, sorry, if I allow you 1000 units, say for example, if I allow you 1000, you tell me how much, if I allow you 1000 to divide by 1000, right? Then you tell me what is, just give me a minute. If I allow you to divide by 1000, can you all tell me what will be your cost per unit, fixed production overhead per unit? If we divide 5 lakhs by 1000, what will be my cost per unit? On your chat box, 500? Okay, ab dhyan dena. Accounting standard board aisa kehta hai ki agar hum aapko allow karenge 500 rupaye ek unit pe, aapne actually kitna manufacture kiya hai? How much have you manufactured actually in case 3? On your chat box, how much have you manufactured actually in case 3? 1200? So this I will multiply by 1200. How much do you get? 6 lakh rupees. Dhyan dena please. Wo aisa bol rahe hain ki agar aap humko, hum aapko 1000 rupees se divide karne denge, to us case mein आपका पर यूनिट कॉस्ट 500 आएगा. आप मल्टीप्लाई करोगे टोटल कॉस्ट ढूंढने के लिए, एक्चुअल नंबर ऑफ यूनिट से आप मल्टीप्लाई करेंगे. जब आप मल्टीप्लाई करेंगे तो आपका आंसर आएगा 6 लाख. द अकाउंटिंग स्टैंडर्ड बोर्ड इज आस्किंग यू हाउ कैन वी अलाउ यू टू टेक टोटल कॉस्ट 6 लाख व्हेन योर एक्चुअल टोटल कॉस्ट इज ओनली रुपीज 5 लाख, व्हिच मींस वी कैनॉट अलाउ यू टू ओवर अलोकेट योर रिसोर्सेज. आपका टोटल खर्चा एक्चुअली कितना हुआ है? 5 लाख रुपए. हम आपको अगर 1000 से डिवाइड करने देंगे तो एक यूनिट का खर्चा आएगा 500. 500 डिवाइड बाय एक्चुअल प्रोडक्शन, आपका टोटल फिक्स प्रोडक्शन कॉस्ट आ जाएगा 600 रुपए. जब आपका खर्चा टोटल ही 500 रुपए हुआ है तो हम आपको 600 कैसे अलोकेट करने देंगे? दैट्स नॉट पॉसिबल. इससे अच्छा आप ऐसा करेंगे, 415 एक की कॉस्ट है मल्टीप्लाइड बाय 1200. हाउ मच डू यू गेट? 415. into 1200, you will get somewhere close to 5 lakhs. That is what you have actually spent. So in this case, your overhead recovery rate will be reduced from 500 to 415. Are you getting it? Your overhead recovery rate will suitably reduce. Why? Because you have done over allocation of, you have done over utilization of your resources and you have produced more than your capacity. Right, now last point, then I will take your doubts. If you don't understand, I'll repeat also for you, but pay attention. आप में से किसी को तो ऐसा डाउट होना चाहिए कि सर ये कैसी बात हुई, इसने तो अच्छे से प्रोड्यूस किया, करेक्टली प्रोड्यूस किया, तो भी इसको 415 रुपए ही कॉस्ट में ऐड करने दे रहे हैं, इसकी इन्वेंटरी 415 रुपए से ही बढ़ेगी, जबकि इन दोनों ने उससे कम रिसोर्सेज यूटिलाइज ढंग से किए, तो भी ये लोग 500 रुपए ऐड करेंगे. नाउ आई विल टेल यू व्हाट डू वी डू. एवरीवन ऑन योर चैट बॉक्स, माय क्वेश्चन टू यू इज, व्हाई डू यू डू business in order to show inventory properly or in order to earn profit? My question to you is, why do you do business? To show good inventory or to earn profits? Of course, you do it to earn profits. Ab dhyan dena. इस केस में क्या होगा, केस वन केस टू केस थ्री, केस वन केस टू केस थ्री में क्या होगा, ध्यान देना. द मीनिंग ऑफ ओवरहेड रिकवरी रेट प्रूवा मींस द फिक्स्ड प्रोडक्शन ओवरहेड पर यूनिट इज आल्सो नोन एज ओवरहेड रिकवरी रेट. राइट, अब ध्यान देना. मान लो इन तीनों के लिए मटीरियल कॉस्ट इज रुपीज 100, मान लो. सो मटीरियल कॉस्ट यू विल हैव रुपीज 100 फॉर ऑल थ्री. So material cost is rupees 100, same for all the three. Aisa maan lo freight is also the same for all the three. Third case, aisa maan lo ki direct labor is also the same. 10, right, which means till this point your total cost is the same, 100 plus 20 plus 10 is how much, 130. So you have over here 130. Dhyan dena please, if you understand this you will understand everything. Ab aata hai fixed production overhead. Fixed production overhead, A ka hamara kitna aaya, 500. B का कितना आया, 500. थर्ड केस मतलब सॉरी नॉट बी, केस वन का कितना आया, 500. केस टू का कितना आया, 500. और केस थ्री का आया 415. राइट, ये तीन केस का हमको मिला. यहाँ पे आपको मिलेगा टोटल कॉस्ट, लेकिन ऐसा मान लो कि इन सबके पास एक फिक्स्ड सेलिंग प्राइस है. लेट्स पुट दैट फर्स्ट, दे ऑल हैव अ फिक्स्ड सेलिंग प्राइस ऑफ 700. Everyone is selling at the same price of rupees 700. Let's calculate. What's your total cost? Your total cost over here is 130 plus 500. 630, same cost is over here. Over here, what's your cost? 415. Now see why the Accounting Standard Board has calculated this and has made this as a provision. Please understand that. Everyone on your chat box, let's also calculate the profit. You have 70. You have 70. Over here, you will have 155. Tell me, who is earning more profits? A, B, or C? Case 1, case 2, case 3. Case 1, case 2, case 3. Quickly on your chat box, who is earning more profit? Case 3. Right, okay. Next important point, dhyan dena. Who is in the best position? You said case 3. Who is in the second best position? Case 1, case 2, both or any one of them? Who is in the who is in the second best position? Case 1, case 2 or both? केस वन. ओके नाउ प्लीज अंडरस्टैंड, हम लोग बिजनेस करते हैं प्रॉफिट कमाने के लिए. प्रॉफिट कमाना है तो ये दो काम आप कर सकते हो, या तो अपना सेलिंग प्राइस बढ़ा दो या तो अपना कॉस्ट रिड्यूस करो. कॉस्ट कैसे रिड्यूस हो सकता है? बाय ऑप्टिमम यूटिलाइजेशन ऑफ रिसोर्सेस. अकाउंटिंग स्टैंडर्ड बोर्ड ऐसा कहता है कि इन्वेंटरी को मैनिपुलेट करने के लिए आप अपना प्रोडक्शन प्लान मत करो कि कम प्रोड्यूस करूंगा तो कॉस्ट बढ़ेगा, ऑटोमेटिकली इन्वेंटरी बढ़ेगी, मेरा प्रॉफिट बढ़ेगा, मेरा फाइनेंशियल पोजीशन बढ़ेगा. ये सब मत करो. आपने बिजनेस ये सब करने के लिए किया है, ये सब करने के लिए नहीं किया है. आपने बिजनेस प्रॉफिट अर्न करने के लिए किया है. ये सोचो प्रॉफिट ज्यादा कैसे यू कैन अर्न प्रॉफिट बाय यूटिलाइजिंग योर रिसोर्सेज प्रॉपर्ली सो दैट योर कॉस्ट पर यूनिट इज रिड्यूस्ड. इफ योर कॉस्ट पर यूनिट इज रिड्यूस्ड ऑटोमेटिकली कंपेयर टू योर सेलिंग प्राइस योर प्रॉफिट विल इंक्रीज. नाउ बिकॉज केस थ्री हैज डन द मोस्ट ऑप्टिमम यूटिलाइजेशन ऑफ रिसोर्सेज, केस थ्री का प्रॉफिट सबसे ज्यादा है, दैट इज ₹155. If you ask me, second best position पे case 2 है क्योंकि उसको ₹70 का profit हुआ है. So case 3 is at position 1, case 1 is at position 2. अब देखो case 3 को क्या होगा, आपको ऐसा लगेगा case 3 भी 70 का profit earn कर रहा है. Case 3 को 70 का gross profit तो मिल जाएगा, लेकिन जैसे ही वो profit and loss account में जाएगा, ये ₹125 उसका wait कर रहा है वहां पे. जैसे ही वो आएगा 125 will be debited from the profit and loss account, automatically it will be at a loss, which means if you have underutilization of resources, it will ultimately cause some kind of loss to you. Are you understanding? If you have underutilization of resources, it will cost some kind of loss to you. That is why it is important that you have optimum utilization of your resources, and optimum utilization will always fetch you higher profits. You can see that you will always get higher profits over here. Are you getting it? Quickly, everyone, each and everyone on your chat box, are you clear with this? This is a very important case. You have two questions coming up next on this, so please tell me, are you clear with this? If you have any questions, I will solve that to you. But everyone on your chat box, are you clear with this? If you want, I will repeat it for you 10 times. You ask me, that's it. I will repeat it for you 10 times. But you should be thoroughly clear with this. Right? So, Akshay, Aman, Anjali, Aksa, Bhavin, Deepak, Deepesh, Dhara, Digesh, Tulsi, Harshit, Het, Ishika, Ishita, काजल, खुशी, मानव, नक्षिका, ओम, पवन, पुष्टि, राघव, राज, रोहन, समी, समिता, शिफा, श्रेयस, सिमरन, स्प्रुहा, सृष्टि, वेद एंड यश. आर यू ऑल क्लियर विद दिस? इज द कंसेप्ट क्लियर टू यू? ऑन योर चैट बॉक्स, इफ यू आर नॉट क्लियर, प्लीज आस्क मी. Are you all absolutely clear with this? Yes or no? Okay. I guess I have one doubt. Yes. So it says, so there is one doubt which says, when actual production is more than it is written, then recovery rate will be low. Please explain that. Of course, I'll explain that to you. See how that is done is, what's your recovery? See, this is your recovery rate. Ek unit pe aap kitna allocate karoge, that is known as recovery rate. Now, this doubt is, I think, of Ishita. Okay, Ishita, please understand this. Recovery rate ka matlab ye hai. Pehle to usko recovery rate kyun kehte hai, wo main aapko samjhata hu. Aapko costing mein bhi, of course, padhayenge, but I'll explain to you. Recovery rate ka matlab ye hai, ki humne 5 lakh rupay ka kharcha kiya. मान लो 5 लाख रुपए का खर्चा किया. अब वो 5 लाख रुपए हमने जो खर्चा किया वो रिकवर तो करना पड़ेगा. तो हम कैसे रिकवर करेंगे? हर एक यूनिट पे हम उसको 1000 यूनिट पे अलोकेट कर देंगे. मतलब हर एक यूनिट पे कुछ कॉस्ट ऐड करेंगे ताकि सारे यूनिट बिक जाए तो पूरा 5 लाख हमको रिकवर हो जाएगा. हमारे पास कितने यूनिट है इस केस में? 1000 यूनिट है. अगर नॉर्मल कैपेसिटी लेते हैं, एक्चुअल कैपेसिटी लोगे तो 1200 है. मतलब सारा 5 लाख रुपए कौन अलोकेट करेगा? हमारे लिए 1200 यूनिट अलोकेट करेंगे. तो इसलिए हम क्या करते हैं 5 लाख डिवाइड बाय 1200 क्या आया 415। 415 अगर एक एक यूनिट पे हम चार्ज करने लगे और फिर बेचने लगे तो जब सारे यूनिट बिक जाएंगे हमारा पूरा कॉस्ट हमको रिकवर हो जाएगा, इसीलिए उसको क्या कहते हैं ओवरहेड रिकवरी कॉस्ट। आपका ओवरहेड रिकवर किस रेट पे होगा, 500 रुपए पर यूनिट पे या 415 रुपए पर यूनिट पे आपका ओवरहेड रिकवर होगा पर यूनिट, ये कंसेप्ट है उसका। अब आते हैं व्हाई डज इट लोअर। आपका ओरिजिनल ओवरहेड रिकवरी रेट कितना था 500 रुपए, क्योंकि आपका पर क्योंकि आपने टोटल प्रोडक्शन बढ़ा दिया पर यूनिट कॉस्ट घट गया और पर यूनिट कॉस्ट कितना आ गया 415 रुपए, विच मीन्स योर ओवरहेड रिकवरी रेट विच वॉज 500 रुपीज अर्लियर हैज नाउ रिड्यूस टू 415। सो बिकॉज इट इज रिड्यूस टू 415 they are saying that whenever the actual capacity is more than the normal capacity of production, in that case you will always have reduction in your overhead recovery rate. Right, Ishita, is that clear to you? Yes or no? I hope that clears your doubt. Okay, great. I have one more doubt, which says how fixed production overhead is indirect cost of cost, example please. Okay, fixed production overheads, I think you would have studied this in costing, but I will explain to you again. For example, if I talk about raw material, right, please pay attention. I think, let me check whose doubt it is. Okay, I think Sami, it is your doubt, so please understand this carefully. Today all factories are locked, no factory is working. So Sami, my question to you is, will you have raw material cost today? Yes or no? क्योंकि आज सारी फैक्ट्री बंद है, कोई प्रोडक्शन नहीं हो रहा, क्या आपको रॉ मटेरियल होने वाला है? नहीं। क्या आपको डायरेक्ट लेबर होने वाला है, डायरेक्ट लेबर का कॉस्ट होने वाला है? यस और नो? नो। मान लो फैक्ट्री चालू हो जाती है कल से, तो डायरेक्ट लेबर का कॉस्ट होगा, यस और नो? क्या रॉ मटेरियल का कॉस्ट होगा अगर कल से फैक्ट्री चालू हो जाती है? यस। नाउ दिस इज नोन एज वेरिएबल प्रोडक्शन ओवरहेड्स। I think Raj, you had also asked me this variable production overheads. I missed your doubt earlier, so please pay attention. Variable production overheads कहते हैं इसको, because it is changing with your number of production. Sami, question number 3 to you. If you produce 1000 units, if you produce 1000 units, and one unit requires one unit of raw material, एक product बनाने के लिए एक raw material चाहिए, तो 1000 यूनिट बनाने के लिए कितना रॉ मटेरियल चाहिए? फिर से पूछ रहा हूं, एक यूनिट बनाना हो तो एक रॉ मटेरियल चाहिए, मुझे 1000 यूनिट बनाने तो कितने रॉ मटेरियल चाहिए? ऑन योर चैट बॉक्स 1000। ओके, मान लीजिए कल से मैं डिसाइड करता हूं, आज से मैं 1500 यूनिट बनाऊंगा। अब बताइए कितना कितना रॉ मटेरियल के यूनिट चाहिए? 1500, okay. Which means, put it on the chat box, yes or no. The moment your production is changing, is your raw material consumption also changing, yes or no? Yes, this is known as variable overheads, which will vary with your variation in the production. Okay, अब example number 2 लेते हैं। आप जो factory चला रहे हो, उसका rent है 50,000 per month. अभी इस वक्त फैक्ट्री बंद है, कोई प्रोडक्शन नहीं हो रहा, और आपको आपके लैंडलॉर्ड ने बोल दिया है कि हम रेंट भी माफ नहीं करने वाले हैं। आप मुझे बताइए कितना रेंट पे करना पड़ेगा पर मंथ? फैक्ट्री बंद है फिर भी पे करना पड़ेगा, यस और नो? यस। ओके, मान लो फैक्ट्री चालू है, आपकी कैपेसिटी 1000 है, लेकिन आप 5000 यूनिट्स बनाते हो। ध्यान देना, आपकी कैपेसिटी 1000 है, आप 5000 यूनिट्स बनाते हो, क्या रेंट चेंज हो जाएगा या उतना ही रहेगा उस प्रीमाइसेस का? विल इट रिमेन द सेम और विल इट चेंज? द लैंडलॉर्ड विल टेल यू कि आप तो बहुत प्रोडक्शन कर रहे हो हमारी फैक्ट्री में, आप हमको ज्यादा रेंट दो। आप क्या बोलोगे? देखो, हमने आपसे प्रॉपर्टी रेंट पे ली है, प्रॉपर्टी के अंदर हमको जितना भी मैन्युफैक्चरिंग करना वो हमारे ऊपर है, उसका प्रोडक्ट उसका आपसे रेंट, आपके रेंट से कोई लेना देना नहीं, विच मीन्स योर रेंट रिमेन्स फिक्स्ड इररिस्पेक्टिव वेदर ऑफ कंपनी इज रनिंग और नॉट, और इररिस्पेक्टिव ऑफ योर लेवल ऑफ प्रोडक्शन. दैट इज व्हाई दे आर सेइंग दैट दिस रेंट इज योर फिक्स्ड प्रोडक्शन ओवरहेड्स. आर यू गेटिंग इट? इट मीन्स इट इज योर फिक्स्ड प्रोडक्शन ओवरहेड्स. Right, this is the example that you can have of fixed production overheads, right? So Sami, I hope it is clear to you. Yes or no? I hope this is clear. Okay, excellent. Come to the next one. I have one more doubt which says, sir, in case 2, suppose if we produce 800 units and nothing is sold, then what should be the loss? Your loss will still remain the same. Your loss will still remain the same. Because you will sell it, if you do not sell it today, you will sell it someday later. So automatically it will show as a loss to you. Your P&L will be debited. How much means, what are you talking about, how much? So whenever you will sell, the number of units that you will sell, the loss will be there. So take one example. You want to take 0 units sold, or you want to take some number of units to be sold? Zero units sold, okay. Then prepare your profit and loss account. In the profit and loss account, you will have 0 sale. Yes or no? In the P&L, you will have 0 sale. Let's assume this is the only unit. Then we'll be able to understand the effect. So if I talk about the P&L credit side, this is the debit side, this is the credit side. What's your sale? 0. What's your value of inventory? 500. On the debit side, let's assume no cost, nothing. What's your profit? What's your profit? Quickly on the chat box, what's your profit in this case? 500. This profit will go to the profit and loss account opening balance. There you already have 125 waiting for you. What's your total loss? What's your profit now? What's your profit? 325. ये 500 जो आपका GP था, वो आपका opening हुआ ना for the profit and loss account. 125. So you have 375. So if you sell 0 units, still you will have 375 as your profit. I hope that is clear to you now. Okay, I have one more doubt which says, what is the difference between cost directly related to production and variable cost? So variable cost can be of your number of units that you use. Variable cost can be of your quality control, which will happen only when you have production. That is cost directly, that is your variable overheads. Cost directly relating to production means whatever cost you will take, that directly affects your production activities, then it is known as production. So that production cost can be other than your regular variable cost. Your regular variable cost is your raw material cost, your direct labor, your direct overhead. These are your variable overheads. Apart from this, if you have anything else, that will also be called as cost directly relating to production. Right? Jo aapke production ko directly impact karta hai. So basically there is a thin line difference, but they have categorized it this way. Right, so Spruha, I hope that is also clear to you. Yes or no? Okay, let's go to the next one. Let's read this again. Now you'll be able to better understand this. It says, if actual capacity is equal to normal capacity of production, there is no under recovery of overheads, which means you प्रोड्यूस करेक्टली, जितने यूनिट्स प्रोड्यूस करने चाहिए उतने ही प्रोड्यूस किए, सो देयर इज नो अंडर रिकवरी और ओवर रिकवरी ऑफ ओवरहेड्स. इफ एक्चुअल प्रोडक्शन इज लोअर देन नॉर्मल कैपेसिटी देन देयर इज अंडर रिकवरी ऑफ ओवरहेड्स. ध्यान देना, डू नॉट कंसिडर अनअब्सॉर्ब्ड ओवरहेड्स फॉर वैल्यूएशन ऑफ इन्वेंट्री. यू विल ऑलवेज ट्रीट इट एज अ पीरियड कॉस्ट. सो यू विल ऑलवेज ट्रीट इट एज अ पीरियड कॉस्ट. In the third case, your actual production is higher than normal capacity. There is over absorption of overheads. Your overhead recovery rate will be suitably lowered. This ensures that inventories are not measured above cost. So you will always reduce it at lower cost. देखो ये भी हमने देखा. This will ensure that inventories are not measured above cost. तो हमारा cost कितना था? Tell me on the chat box, how much was your total fixed production overheads in the question? ₹5 lakhs. Okay, so you will have 5 lakhs. Now what happens is, if they allow you to take 500 rupees, we were reaching to 6 lakhs, par wo unhone allow nahi kiya. Matlab when you reduce the overhead recovery rate suitably low, at that time what will happen? You will ensure that your inventory cost never increases beyond 5 lakh rupees. Wohi point wo log yahan pe samjha rahe. This ensures that inventory costs are never measured above cost. So aapka 5 lakh rupees se upar kabhi bhi cost jayega nahi. Are you getting it? Okay, before I go to question number 4 and we understand that, let me take one doubt, which says you gave example of direct labor for variable overheads, whereas in material it is given for cost. Now Spruha, please understand, you have asked me a general question. See, look at this question that you have asked me. You are saying, then what is the difference between cost directly relating to production and variable overheads? So the answer that I give you is correct for this. Now if you look at the study material, I told you earlier, they have divided the study material into two parts. One is for purchase of raw material, and the second one, just give me a minute, yes, one for purchase of raw material and the other is for cost of conversion. That is why they have divided it into two parts. जहां पे वो कह रहे रॉ मटेरियल खरीदना है तो डायरेक्टली एट्रिब्यूटेबल कॉस्ट है. अब मैं आपको एक और एग्जाम्पल देता हूँ. सिर्फ रॉ मटेरियल परचेज करना इज नॉट डायरेक्टली एट्रिब्यूटेबल कॉस्ट. अगर आप इंश्योरेंस पे कर रहे हो, दैट इज ऑल्सो डायरेक्टली एट्रिब्यूटेबल कॉस्ट. मीन्स कॉस्ट डायरेक्टली रिलेटिंग टू प्रोडक्शन, राइट? इफ यू हैव टेकन इंश्योरेंस ऑफ अ मशीनरी सो दैट योर प्रोडक्शन इज प्रॉपर एंड देयर इज नो प्रॉब्लम, अगेन दैट इज अ कॉस्ट डायरेक्टली एट्रिब्यूटेबल और डायरेक्टली रिलेटिंग टू प्रोडक्शन. So if you want to understand from the study material viewpoint, then whenever you have purchase of raw materials, that is the time you will look at the first case. When you want to look at the cost of conversion, that is the time when you will look at the second case that we are discussing, right? So if, say for example, if we are talking about cost directly relating to production, then you will look at the raw material. However, if you want to talk about variable overheads, about cost of conversion, then you will be considering that for your cost of conversion, right? So Spruha, I hope that is now clear to you. If you have any doubts, please ask me. So if you want a generalized answer, a general answer for the entire question, then what I have said is correct. If you want specifically, then you will have to divide it into categories. Material purchase cost, then it will go otherwise. Raw material, then you cost of conversion, then you will have variable overheads, direct labor, right? I hope that is clear to you. If not, please post your doubt, right? I hope you are absolutely clear with that. So whenever you have, see, cost is something the definition of which will be very subjective. It will change from situation to situation. So it is important that you understand what context are you talking about. Because you're purchasing raw material, you have to see the directly related cost. However, if you're talking about converting raw material into WIP, then you will have to see the variable cost as well, right? So I hope that is clear to you. I have one more doubt, which says, how come we have profit if we haven't sold anything? What about cost of production? Now Raj, you told me that you have zero sales, so you wanted to understand the impact. So that is why I have taken this example. Now in this example, you tell me, what is your production cost? I will take that also. This is simple profit and loss account calculation that you have to make. So you put it on the chat box, what cost of production you need, accordingly your profit will reduce to that extent. However, if you have studied final accounts, you will understand that your profitability is determined by your sales, your value of the inventory, and also your items going out of business other than sales. So because your closing value of inventory is there, you have book profit of 500. You may not have cash profit, but you have book profit of 500. So that is why you have this. So you tell me what is the production cost that you want to take. I will put it over here and you will get your values. Right, so you tell me what are the values. You take example number two, tell me the values. I'll prepare the account and show it to you. Tell me what values do you want to take. In case two, I have taken actual sale. Do you want to take sale? First, let's be clear with that. Are you really wanting to take sale? Put it up over here, please. So tell me, what sale do you want? No sales, so your sales in the... You want P&L account? Is that what you want? Do you want P&L account? What should I prepare? Okay, so let's call this P&L. And let's call this manufacturing account. Okay, tell me, what do you want to do next? Okay, tell me, what do you want to do next? Units produced. Okay, what's your cost per unit? Calculate 130 into 800. How much do you get? So should I debit 1,04,000 as your production cost? Okay, done. Then what next? Sales, as you said, zero. Then what next? Fixed overhead is 500. Okay, take that 500. But fixed production overheads, should you add? Yes, so what's your total fixed production overheads? Total fixed production overheads. Total fixed. Oh, okay. So what you do is you could record this doubt and send it to me on personal message. I'll do it. But let me tell you one thing before you do that. I don't want your effort to be wasted. So please understand. What you should do in this case is, first you decide, do you want to take it per unit and understand the impact? I think understanding the impact per unit will be helpful rather than taking overall. Second, if you say fixed overheads 500, then decide whether it will be cost as a part of your cost of inventory or is it period cost? Because if it is a part of your cost of inventory, you need to also calculate purchase cost plus any other direct expenses plus fixed production overhead. Then you will get cost of inventory, which you will multiply by 800 units. So you have to first properly frame your question. So I request you to frame your question, send it to me on my personal message and I will solve that for you. I request you to do it today itself so that your doubt is clear. Okay, let's proceed then. If I hope all doubts are now solved, let's proceed to the next one. Come to question number four. Let's solve this. Question number four. I guess this should be the last question for today. Come to question number four. Question number four, which is given to you on page number 22. Page 22, question number 4. Your normal capacity of production is 1 lakh. Your fixed production overheads is 5 lakhs. Your actual production for case 1 is 1 lakh. Case 2 is 80,000. And case 3 is 1,25,000. Karna kya hai? Discuss how fixed production overheads will be allocated to your inventory. Okay, so we have to explain over here how fixed production overheads will be allocated to the inventory. Right, put your first statement as per accounting standard 2, valuation of inventory. Put your first statement as per accounting standard 2, valuation of inventory. Kya karna hai question mein? Allocation of fixed production overheads. Allocation of fixed production overheads to inventory. Allocation of fixed production overheads to inventory. Let's prepare the format. Case. Overheads recovered, prepare format systematically. Overheads treated and its period cost. Okay, I have one doubt which says page 21 in lower or greater than both case. So if you pay attention to this question, Akshay, you will clearly understand lower than or greater than. So please pay attention. You will be clear. Still, if there are any doubts, we'll take that after this. So please pay attention to this question. Your doubts will be cleared. Prepare your format. Fixed production overhead recovery rate. What's the formula? The formula is total fixed production overheads divided by normal capacity of production. total fixed production overheads divided by normal capacity of production. This is your formula. Let's take case one. Okay, everyone, please pay attention. Let's take case one and understand it. Case one, what's your overhead recovery rate? So tell me, case one, rightly produced, under absorbed or over absorbed on your chat box. Case number one, rightly produced, over absorbed, under absorbed. Rightly produced, over absorbed or under absorbed. Case one, quickly on your chat box. Rightly produced, okay. Since it is rightly produced, you had to produce 1 lakh units, you actually produced 1 lakh. So your fixed production overhead per unit will be over here 5 lakhs divided by 1 lakh, which will be rupees 5. Let's calculate how much overheads did you recover. अब देखो किसी ने मुझे पूछा था overhead recovery rate, यहाँ पे मैं समझाता हूँ. How much overheads did you recover? ध्यान देना. एक यूनिट पे मैंने 5 रुपए रिकवर किए. मैंने एक्चुअली कितने यूनिट्स बनाए हैं? 1 लाख. तो मैंने टोटल रिकवर कितना किया? 5 लाख. Are you getting it? I hope you all are clear with this. I think it was Ishita's doubt, if I'm not mistaken. So Ishita, this is a practical example. कितना रिकवर किया? एक यूनिट पे 5 रुपए रिकवर किया. वो कहां से मिला? ये रहा ओवरहेड रिकवरी रेट 5 रुपए. और टोटल यूनिट्स एक्चुअली कितने बनाए? 1 लाख. तो 5 into 1 lakh comes to how much? 5 lakhs. तो एक्चुअली मैंने कितना रिकवर कर लिया? 5 lakh rupees. Right? I hope Ishita that is clear to you. Yes or no? Okay, if that is clear and if everyone is clear, tell me, will you have anything going to the profit and loss account in this case? Yes or no? No. So you will have nil over here, zero. What's your total cost that you have? 5 lakhs. Your total cost will be how much? 5 lakh rupees. Okay, let's take case two. Case two, how much did you manufacture? Case two, how much did you manufacture? Quickly on your chat box. Case two, how much did you manufacture? 80,000. Okay, let's try and find out the overhead recovery rate. Dhyan dena. 5 lakh divided by 80,000. Okay, Akshay, since this is your doubt, I'll take your help. Akshay, 5 lakh into 80,000, how much do you get? Please calculate for me. How much do you get? Akshay, since you have not understood case 2, case 3, I would like to take your help. So please tell me. You get how much? 6.25. Okay. In this case, Akshay, is it under recovery or over recovery? Akshay, under recovery, over recovery. Kam manufacture kiya jitna karna tha usse ya zyada manufacture kiya? Less or more? On your chat box, under recovery. Okay. What does accounting standard 2 tell you regarding under recovery? What does accounting standard 2 tell you regarding under recovery? Should I take 80,000 or should I still divide by 1 lakh? Should I take 80,000 or should I divide by 1 lakh? 1 lakh, okay. Now you said divide by 80 comes to 6.25. So 6.25. This, just give me a moment. 6.25 will not be the correct thing. So this will be wrong. Instead of this, what you will do is 5 lakh divided by 1 lakh. How much will you get, Akshay, per unit? Akshay, quickly on the chat box, how much will you get per unit? 5? So you have 5 per unit. Again, एक यूनिट पे आपने 5 रुपए रिकवर किया तो 1 लाख आपने इधर एक्चुअली कितना बनाया? Akshay, how much did you actually manufacture? ₹80,000. Tell me, कितना हमारा recover हुआ? How much could we recover? 4 lakhs? पर actual खर्चा तो 5 लाख है, तो बाकी 1 लाख कहाँ जाएगा? Actual खर्चा 5 लाख है, 4 लाख हमने cost of unit पे अप्लाई किया, बाकी का 1 लाख कहां पे जाएगा? Where will the remaining 1 lakh go? The remaining 1 lakh will be treated as a period cost, exactly, and it will go to the profit and loss account. तो actual खर्चा 6.25 हुआ, पर हमने 5 लिया. देखो, ये भी मैं आपको reconcile करके देता हूं. So your actual cost was rupees 1.25, which will multiply by the number of units that you have, 80,000. You will get how much? So देखो, 6.25 जो total खर्चा था वो divide हो गया 5 rupees and 1.25. Your total cost will still come to 5 lakhs. देखो, कोई भी हालत में 5 lakhs से ज़्यादा यहाँ पे नहीं आएगा. You will get that. In any situation, you will not exceed this. Right, Akshay, quickly on your chat box. I hope you are clear with that. Case 2 is done. Yes or no? Yes, okay, great. Okay, come to the third case. Now, third case. Tell me, on case number 3, how much did we actually produce? Everyone, quickly, how much did we actually produce in case 3? 1,25,000. So we will take 1,25,000. Tell me, what's your overhead recovery rate per unit? You get how much? 4 rupees. Okay. Shifa, if you can explain to me, how will you get the overhead recovery rate? Shifa, if you can explain to me, how do you get the overhead recovery rate? 5 lakhs divided by 1,25,000. Excellent. Okay. What is the total overheads that are recovered in the question? Total overheads recovered in the question. 5 lakhs, how do you get that? How do you get 5 lakhs? How do you get 5 lakhs? Very good. 4 into 1,25,000. You get rupees 5 lakhs. Shifa, will anything go to the profit and loss account in this case? Will anything go to the profit and loss account? Will you have a period cost in this case? No, you will not. Total cost. Okay, I am again repeating for you. You cannot take 1 lakh over here and 5 over here. If you take 5 over here, this will become 5. This will become 5 into 1,25,000. That is 6,25,000. Jab aapka actual kharcha hi 5 lakh rupees hua hai, to aap 6,25,000 PNL mein debit nahi kar sakte, ya cost mein allocate nahi kar sakte. That is why you will allocate only 5 lakh rupees. You will not allocate beyond 5 lakh rupees. Are you understanding? Right, okay. I hope this is clear to you. Now, please listen to what I am saying. Today, we did question number 3. We understood one concept of fixed production overheads, and we did question number 4. You will go back today and revise these questions. Plus, tomorrow we will be doing question number 5. Now, please understand. Question number 5 is a past exam question and is a question based on what we have done today. So, you will thoroughly revise all the concepts today. Tomorrow, when I do question number 5, I will select 3 students from you. And 3 students will help me solve the question as we have done in the other standards. So please ensure you all are prepared and you all can answer tomorrow. Be in that position that you can answer tomorrow. Right? So please be prepared. Please revise whatever we have done. And I hope you remember you have a test on Saturday. So please ensure that you have thoroughly understood, you have thoroughly revised all those standards. You have AS12. AS17 and AS18, these 3 standards you need to revise thoroughly. You have a test of the same on Saturday. Right, I hope that is clear. Thank you so much for attending. And do revise this. Tomorrow, I will ask you to solve the doubts for me. Solve that question number 5 for me. Right, thank you so much for attending. I will now see you tomorrow morning at 8 o'clock. And we continue with Accounting Standard 2. Thank you.